please understand that whenever a child is coming to you, think if somebody is talking to you a lot, they're revealing their feelings, not necessary. Some children are so good, they just come sit for 2 minutes and actually tell you what's going on in their mind. It takes 2 sentences for them to say, this is what's happening in them. So just because somebody is verbose doesn't mean that their real feelings are being revealed. Please keep that in mind when you're talking to children.
But in a school setup, if the teacher comes and tells, you know, this child uses a lot of bad language. Okay. When you're talking to the child, how do you tell the child, don't use the language, or, you know, it's just the way he talks is like that.
That's what I want you to understand, that sometimes teachers tend to get things blown up. Every child uses a bad language, believe me that. You don't have to, no parent teaches a child bad language. This is inherited. No parent teaches a child all the 4-letter words that he needs to know. But at the age of 12, he knows enough 4-letter words that you know about it. Right? He can use some of the choicest words given the choice. You talk to him, if you can hear him when he's talking to his friends, you can discover the choicest words that they can use. Who's taught him? You're not the person who's teaching it. It's a peer group that teaches him, isn't it? If he's using the bad language, apparently the whole class is using the bad language. Believe me that. When they need to, their whole class will be using their bad language. The teacher gets upset because she heard it. Isn't it? Even her own child will be using their bad language. Nothing. That's what I'm saying. When some teacher sends you a child saying that this is a problem with the child, there's nothing like it's a huge problem. Please believe that. Don't take that to be a serious issue. You know, that he's using a bad language, he's drawing some bad pictures in the thing, or he's doing some kind of a disturbance. Something would be there. So don't take it to such a level that he has, I would tell him how to not to talk bad language. You can't even do that, believe me. You can't even stop him from using a bad language.
So how do you take it from how do you do that?
So we come to what is the next part of the session of behavior modification. Because, see, as counselors, what happens is, I can't be strictly here.
See, I'm not a counselor, I'm a teacher. So for me, it is not that a child comes to me every day, it's just that half an hour that I spend in the classroom.
Yeah.
Or that 1.5 hour for the entire week that I spend in the classroom. So how do I address that?
So the next part I want to take a look at is, like, as a school counselor, you can't stop being totally non-direct. Right? As a teacher or as a counselor, you can't be saying that I'll just do only non-direct part, I'll not do it. You need to get direct. How we do it? We'll take a short break of 5 minutes and we'll carry the session forward, right? I'll come back.